Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let me show you how you can create unique video background music using GarageBand. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you could read more about it, join us, and get exclusive content. So whether you're creating a video just to share with your friends and family or to post online, you may want to put some background music in there. And you could take some of the canned music that comes with, say, iMovie, or download something online and use it, but you're going to have the same music used by so many other people online. Apple gives you the tool that you need, GarageBand, to create your own unique background music for your videos, and it only takes a few minutes to do it. So let's start off here by choosing an empty project in GarageBand, and it's going to ask us what type of track we want to start with. We're going to start with the drummer track. Now previously to have a drum track you needed to use a loop, and there were a certain number of drum loops that you could select from. But now you can create a nearly infinite variety of drum loops by using the special drummer track. So on the left here you'll see all these different drummers. You can click on the category here and it jumps up to the category level, and you can choose rock, or you can go to alternative and all these different ones. Then you could choose a drummer, and then from that you can choose different sounds. So already you have a ton of variety there. So we can stick with this sound here, and then we can hit play and hear what it sounds like. Now let's set up the loop. I'm going to loop here by clicking there, and then extend the loop so it covers the sample part of the drum track. Now I can play and it will loop, and anything I change will hear as it just continues to loop around. So let me double click on it here and go back to this interface. The drummer interface allows you to further customize what you get. So you can select from these presets all these different ones. We'll go here, and then you can also move this circle to go between loud and soft, complex and simple. Put it right in the middle, and then we can change what instruments play here. So for instance, I can change the cymbals or toms. I can add tambourine or maracas, hand claps, that kind of thing. So you can really get it to be customized. You can even play with fills and how much swing there is. Let's increase that. So now we have our unique drum track already. So since we're making this for a video background, we already know how long the video is. So say in this case it's 2 minutes. So we want to make sure that the drummer continues playing for those 2 minutes. So let's switch here from beat to time, and we'll see time here at the top. Let's also switch this control so we can see as much time as possible. Close the library here to extend this to cover as much area as we can on the screen. And I can select the top right or the bottom right of this track. This will extend the track. This will extend it as a loop. It doesn't really matter for the drummer. I'm going to extend it here from the bottom. Click and drag. Drag it all the way out. I'm going to go past the end here. We know we want it to go past 2 minutes. So let's go a little bit past 2 minutes and then switch back to beats and project. And now if we try to drag this out, it's going to snap to a measure. And you can see there at the bottom, length 51 measures, 52 measures, 53 measures. So let's have it locked to something like 52 measures. So we know that's a little bit over 2 minutes, and it's exactly 52 measures. So the song won't end in the middle of a measure and sound awkward. So now we have our drummer track. Let's add another one. I'm going to click on loops here, and I'm going to go to instrument, and from instrument I'm going to select bass. Now you could start with anything that you want. You could start, for instance, with synthesizers, a piano, or guitar, or beats. I'm going to do bass here, and I'm going to go in, look at all the different bass samples. So I can click on one and hear it. Click again to have it stop. But what's more useful is if I hit play, and it will play this looped area with my drums, and whatever I click here, it'll play over that. So I can see how it sounds. Now I can go through all of this and test all sorts of different bass beats out. So take your time to select something you think fits the mood of your video. When you find something you like, simply drag and drop it to the new track here at the bottom. Let's hit stop, and now I've got this bass track here. I can again drag it out. If I drag it from the bottom right, I get nothing because there's only this small sample here. I'll undo that, and I'll drag instead from the top right to loop it. And I'm going to extend the loop all the way to the end here. Notice how they line up perfectly because I've done 52 measures here, and it's easy to have 52 measures of this bass beat here. So let me hit play and you hear them together. Great. So now it's time to go to another instrument. So let's turn off bass here and instead go to electric piano. Again, you could choose whatever you want. Maybe electric guitar or something like that would be more your style for the video you're working on. I can go in here and I can click to hear any one of these electric piano samples. And I can keep sampling them and do it with the play button on so I can hear them over the music. So I can find one that I like. So let's choose this one. I could drag this in here as well. Let me hit stop and I'm going to extend that loop to go the entire length of the song. So now I've got three different tracks, a very unique drum track, and then these two loops. Now I can make things sound a little bit more like a real song by dragging some of these tracks over so they don't come in all together. So the drum track will come in first and then bass, and then I can have the piano come in. So now it sounds like this at the start. Now I can go all the way to the other end here and I can see because I dragged it pushes these out. So I can actually leave this like that to have each instrument be removed at the end of the song, or I can adjust which instruments get removed first, do it something like that, or I could just adjust the ends here so that they all end at the same time and we can add a fade out later on to have the song fade out at the end. Now you can add further variety by adding another track in that only comes in every once in a while. So since I've got the whole electric piano thing going on, I'm going to stick with that and find another electric piano piece. So I can sample these different ones and find one I think goes well with this. And I can have that come in here. So let me count the measures and make sure it's kind of an even number of measures. So if we have this come in after say 8 measures here, sound a little bit more natural, and maybe come in twice, then I could turn off the looping here so I can now have the playback head go there and I can hear what it sounds like when that comes in. Now I think in this case it'll sound better if the person playing the electric piano actually stops playing one and starts playing the other. So I'm going to move the playback head right there, select this track, and do Command T for split. You could see that under edit here, split regions at playhead. So I'm going to split right there and then I'm going to move the playhead over there, select it there, and split again. So now I've split off this piece and I can delete it. So now it sounds like whoever's playing electric piano switches what they're playing for 2 measures. I could select this, copy it, and go over another 8 measures and place it right here. So now it comes in twice, and then do the same thing here, splitting and cutting out this piece. And then I've got it playing 4 measures here at the end. So it creates a nice little song. Now to get it to fade out, what I want to do is I want to go to Track and then Show Master Track. Then I want to go to Mix and Show Automation. So I'm going to select the automation track and I'm going to switch to a volume automation. And now I see that line there. And I'm going to click right here near the end to create a dot and another dot here at the very end. Drag that dot down and that's a fade out now. So the end of the song now fades. Now what I would actually do if I was using this in a video is I wouldn't put the fade here in GarageBand. I'd have it play full volume and then cut off abruptly at the end. And then I would add the fade in iMovie or Final Cut. So now that we have a complete song here, all we need to do is export it. I'd go to Share and then do Export Song to Disk. Then I could choose a name, where to save it, and the quality level. AAC high quality is pretty good, or you can even go a little bit higher than that. And then you could take that background music and bring it into your video and you'll have music that is different than any other video online. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.